In this next exercise, we will modify a fixed signal timing to create an actuated signal timing with dual ring. Open node 2062 and go to the Signal Groups tab. The signal groups have already been defined. The through and the right movements share a signal group, and the left turns have their own signal groups. First, we must add the detectors for each movement. Using the detector tool, add 5 detectors and name them accordingly. At the minimum, the presence detection capability should be enabled. Select all the detectors, right-click on any one of them, and create a new attribute dynamic label. Display the name of the detectors, and click OK to save. Now, the labels can be adjusted on top of the detectors. Open Control Plan A in Priority, and change the type from fixed to actuated. Set the number of rings to 2 and remove single entry so that a face in every ring will receive green time when the barrier is crossed. Create a second barrier by dragging the line at the right edge of the timing diagram, just right before phase 5. Now we must define the phases. Barrier 1 will be for the north-south movement, while barrier 2 will have the eastbound approach. For ring 1, phase 1, keep signal group 1 and remove signal group 2. Remove phases 2 and 3 and extend phase 1 to be 45 seconds. Move the interface and shorten it to 5 seconds. And now we can also move the barrier and extend phase 3. Phase 3 should have only signal group 3, so remove signal group 5. For ring 2, add a new phase for the 25 seconds, assign signal group 4, which is the southbound left, add a new phase for 20 seconds, and assign that to signal group 2. For the remaining 5 seconds of the barrier, assign it as an interface. Add a new phase for 34 seconds and assign signal group 5. Finally, add another phase and check interface. Now that we have our phases, it's time to set the parameters in the Actuated tab for each phase. Starting with phase 1, in the Actuated tab, set the recall to minimum, check default, and set the minimum green time to 24 seconds, and the passage time to 3 seconds. For phases 3 and 8, they should be set to recall no, with default activated, with a minimum green time of 10 seconds and a passage time of 3 seconds. However, we are also implementing a gap reduction, so activate the gap reduction in the bottom of the window and set the minimum gap to 1 second, time before reduce to 10 seconds, and time to reduce, 20 seconds. Phase 5 should be set to recall no with a minimum green time of 20 seconds, passage time of 3 seconds. Phase 6 also remains as recall no, with a minimum green time of 10 seconds and a passage time of 3 seconds. It should also be set as the default for Barrier 1, Ring 2. We should also activate the hold option so that it stays green even in the absence of calls until the barrier is reached. Next, we need to set the detectors for the phases. Assign the detectors accordingly in the Detectors tab by clicking on Add and then the detector in the model. Run Replication Priority and open the node. Go to the Simulation Control tab, and here you can observe the operation of the actuated control. In the bottom of the window, you can see the actuated parameters of the signal.